Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our Pops concert, the final concert of the year since we began this November at Christmas time. Time does fly. So tonight we not only salute the seniors for their final performance on stage, but we also want to recognize some teacher that and a friend that's been with us for a long time, that was with us for a long time, not only a great player, a trombone player. And so we're going to dedicate this concert to Mr. Robert Nichols. And it's unfortunate, it's like the third time I have said that we're dedicating a concert to someone. I don't know, last year, if you remember, Chris McDonald, at the same time, came in, the great saxophone player, unfortunately. He passed away, and so we dedicate the spring concert. And, you know, it's like, I don't know, when you get to our age, I guess you kind of stop figuring out about life, that things like this happen, and just kind of sort of like blows your mind. But Bobby was a great human being, a great player. You know, I had a quintet, and every time we try to play, when someone's not there, just that's a job in this matter. We canceled several jobs because it just, it's very difficult. So the kids had the opportunity to perform under him. It was, you know, certainly got a lot. So tonight, we thought that we'd make a little bit, and in different, not so much with the year, but with this group, and obviously with the senior band, we invited some alumni to come in and join it and study with him. So sit, relax. We're going to give you a great program. I just want to make sure that you see, get used to what the exit signs are. In case of an emergency, you use all the exits as we move on up here. Let me take this time to thank you, all of you parents, and everyone that has supported us a great deal. I wish there were more people because Game of Thrones is over. Socks are probably losing. I think they should give them more money. That's basically what it is. Yeah, it's over. Jon Snow went back where he belongs, okay? For you guys to follow that, that's what. But anyway, tonight is about the students. Remember that fourth grader? They squawk, squeak, squawk, and you say, oh my God, what I got myself into? Now that fourth grader is a senior. And for most of these people in senior class, this is basically the end of their career, unless they move on to something else. 9 out of 10, most of the people stop playing after this, which is kind of a shame that we bring in so much. So these people are coming up, so for parents, you know, having, for them to have a great successful mission, as I always say, you get to Symphony Hall by not practicing. So just keep that in mind. Okay, so enough with the saying out there. We, behind the program, there is a form. If you like, this is being taped. Just send that directly to the person, and a CD has been made. So we go to my next favorite thing, which is our cell phones, okay, which need to be put away. Okay, we're finding out that these things are not really healthy for the kids. And it's okay, so they'll pick up everything. We got these incredible things. At the last concert, we got cell rings, people talking, people screaming. That's not what we want in there. Right, so we really appreciate that because they worked very hard for us to do this. So without further ado, please power off everything and let's get going so we can hear some great music. Okay, so we'll start off with Rap Chorus. Thank you, Mr. We did this the opposite of Christmas. So, Mr. Cunningham and the Brockton High School Rap Chorus. So, thank you. Thank you.
In order to make a true change in the world, I will look within myself.
To have acceptance of others, to be more tolerant.
To be kind and considerate person, I will look within myself.
And only then can I make a real change in the world.
Thank you. Good evening, everyone, and welcome to our final concert of the year. Thank you so much for being here. Behind me is the Brockton High Rep Chorus, and that last piece was called Music Changes the World. And we like to believe that here, it does change the world, and it changes these wonderful humans that I get to work with every single day. So we're very lucky. Our next piece is a song from the hit musical TV series called Smash. It was originally sung by Megan Hilty. This next piece is called They Just Keep Moving the Line, and it features a solo by Nora Thomas.
Feel was
Thank you. I'd like to introduce our collaborative pianist for the evening, Mr. Mike Kregler. We also have joining us Mr. Neil Sylvia on the drums. Our next selection is from the 1947 musical Finian's Rainbow, and this tune has really become a standard in the jazz repertoire over the years. This is Old Devil Moon. Thank you very much. The final song we would like to sing comes from the 2005 Broadway musical, Little Women, based on the novel. And it was originally sung by Sutton Foster, who some of you might know from her Broadway roles as well. Tonight, the solo will be sung by freshman Anna Anise. We hope you enjoy Astonishing.
Home was all I ever wanted.
Thank you very much. Next up will be Mr. Cardell and the concert band. Thank you very much. Our first piece is going to kick off our band portion of our tribute to Mr. Nichols, and I would like to, at this point, invite some alumni trombone players to come on out.
vegan. Anyway. They still can't follow rules. At this point, I would like to bring up our lead clarinet player, freshman Kyle Gilder. trumpet. As Mr. McCready would say, it's worth more than you. It has been an absolute pleasure this year working with this group. There are some super, super talented kids on stage, as you can see. And at this point, I'm going to bring up one. Mr. Fantucci and I were just talking about this. There are kids that come along every once in a while, and 20 years from now, 30 years from now, you're still talking about those kids. You know, there's kids that Mr. McCready had when he was first starting out, and he still talks to the kids about, we got one right now, and I know I'm making his head bigger than it already is. But it has been a joy to know this kid so far since he was sixth grade, and I can't wait to see what his future brings musically. So at this point, I'd like to bring up Maisel Samba. He's showing off now, no music. And we're gonna play a piece that was actually turned on to me by Mr. Macrina. It's one of his favorite songs. This is the theme song from the movie Cinema Paradiso.
Thank you.
told you. You know a kid is good when other kids in the band say, "Can he do that again?" No, not with the band. I just want to listen to him by himself. Nice job, Maisel. We're going to finish up. The music industry lost a great, great, great artist this past year. One of my favorites. And it was one of the first artists that really started my love of listening to old school R&B and the Blues Brothers movie and all that kind of stuff. So we're going to do three songs from Aretha Franklin, the Queen of Soul. Thank you very much. Please be patient. We're going to do one big set change. We'll bring the concert choir, concert choir up with Mr. Cunningham, and the advanced concert band will take the stage at that time also. Thank you.
Next up, we have the Brockton High School Concert Choir, and our first piece for you this evening is a song from the 1988 film Working Girl. I don't know if you've ever seen that movie, but music and lyrics are by Carly Simon. And Simon actually wrote about the song that she found inspiration for the lyrics from reading the script of the movie, but also poems of Walt Whitman. Musically, she wanted to write a hymn to New York City with a contemporary jungle beat under it. The river that she's referring to is, of course, the Hudson River, literally, but metaphorically it refers to the river of our lives. And the song encourages us to make the most of chances given to us as it proclaims, "Let all the dreamers wake the nation." So we hope you enjoy our first piece, "Let the River Run."
When I wake up in the morning, the
Thank you so much. This choir has just had an incredible year, from performing at the Eastern Division NAFME Conference in Pittsburgh, to getting 2 gold medals at the Micah Festival this year, to recently being named a national finalist in the American Prize for Choral Performance. Our accomplishments this year really have been led incredible senior class, filled with individuals who no doubt will change the world when they go into it. And these students are as kind as they are talented, and that's a testament to you parents. So how about a round of applause for you parents? Thank you for entrusting me with your children every single day to make music. It has been such a pleasure for the past 4 years with this senior class. I'm gonna miss them. Yes. If our seniors now, our 31 seniors of the class of 2019, could raise their hand and be recognized. We would now like to sing for you our graduation song this year. It is from the musical Wicked. Lots of musicals tonight, you can tell I love musical theater. And this song is For Good. It's going to feature a solo by Jade Etienne and by Hope Alexiou. Thank you so much. Before our final selection, one more round of applause, please, for our good friend Mike Kregler. Tonight has been a very exciting night, and we're hoping that's going to continue after the concert. If you were involved in our production of Newsies, which took place a couple of weeks ago, you know that tonight are the MET Award nominations. And if you are a parent of a student involved in that show, we invite you to the Little Theater after this concert to watch the broadcast of those nominations. These students will be heading there after the concert, and keep your fingers crossed for us that we get some nominations. So. Let's have some fun. Our last piece is Rollo Dilworth's Take Me to the Water.
Take me to the river, so that my spirit.
Thank you, a set change, and Mr. Macrina's band will come on and finish it up. Thank you.
Before we start our last program, we have a couple of presentations that we usually do at this time, and we'll do this very quickly. There are two scholarships that we have been given for many, many years. Well, one for many years, almost 29 years at Pop's concert. This scholarship is from his son, who graduated here, Bob Levitt. Graduated, I think, in 1975, 76, in memory of his father, David Levitt, who was a great, great musician in the Brockton area, lawyer, and I know him back in 1966 when he used to play with the Brockton Symphony, and he introduced me to the Brockton Symphony, and from then on I started performing that, and it was my way to get into the music, and he was just a wonderful, wonderful musician, loved kids, loved music education, and so when he passed away, his son started a scholarship that we actually have been giving him close to 30 years. So this, he usually drives all the way from, flies from Atlanta, Georgia, come down, but this evening he's not going to be able to do so. I will have the honor of presenting this. And the criteria is to choose someone that is going to into the music program. That's a pretty standard situation. Last year we had no one, so the award was not given. So it is my pleasure to present this year to a student that is pursuing his career into music. He's been with us for about 4 years, done a great job, a great player. And so I'd like to present the first of this scholarship to Dominic Spady. Several friends, I have nothing to do with this, and they send me the form in, And this year, every year we choose a greeting. So congratulations to all of you. And Mr. Ivy, did you bring a horn with you? Not tonight. Okay.
Should have worn, absolutely.
All right, thank you. Studied with him, and you remember what a great person. So there are another piece of music that we can start off, but to show really what Bob was all about, and I'm sure he's listening up there practicing with us along and playing along with us, is a great rendition of 76 Trombones, Carol Thomas, this is also for you.
Thank you.
Good sound, huh? I just want to say the performance for us, we were Andy Hatchfield. Andy's now the band director of East Bridgewater and Nate Carrellis, playing professionally around the area. Jared Cowell, just going to start with the music with Summer Company, which is great to have him back here. Ryan Shaw, who played with us last year, is at BU. Nick Vontes and Kevin Torres were alumni there to help us along. On the next one here, we have for you, as we, Matt was mentioned in the performance of Mike and so on, so I'd like to mention our wind ensemble that went to the Big Apple Classics in April, and we're very, very fortunate. This is the concert band, the wind ensemble, was the small version, the honors group out of this group, and they did a fabulous job. First of all, they came in first in instrumental music. Actually, they won the overall instrumental ensemble from all the people over there. So, all the ensemble people, stand up, please, stand up. Thank you. And I do have to say that I was surprised at how well they performed that piece. I told them after we were done, I said, this is an outstanding performance. And they really did. And some of the judges that came up to us, you don't want to get off the stage. He just said nothing but great things. And I do have to say that this group really worked hard to achieve the difficult pieces that we performed this year. So you guys did a great job. I'm really proud of you. So after we had all that thing, we went and had some fun on Broadway. And we, thanks to the Boosters Association, we got some money, about $8,000 worth, for tickets to see Aladdin. I thoroughly enjoyed for them to see a Broadway show. Actually, I met one of my students that graduated here, was playing in the pit down there. So they had a great time. So I figured, well, you know, they love this so much, we'll do it for the Boston Pops, if we have the Boston Pops, for our own Pops. Yeah, same thing, right? Yeah. So anyway, here's a little selections and a little memory of our trip for selections from Aladdin.
Thank you.
The last song we're going to play for you, which is not this one yet, I gave him a challenge. It's kind of a difficult shot. And I said, you got 2 weeks to fix it. I mean, to do it. And there's an example when they put their minds, they can do anything. So don't let them say, I can't do this. I said, no, no. In 2 weeks, they put something, it probably could take about a month and a half. So when they put their minds on it, they can do anything, right? So we had time. So I figured, okay, let me see if I can find something to sneak in. Well, I did this little tune a long, long time ago, and one of my strong features in this particular year has been our senior flute players. So I thought it was kind of a cute thing, almost like a Pops fill-in. So we're going to feature. So let's call. I wrote these down because, you know, if you forget the names, dear God, I'm off the Christmas list right away. So, Mary Perdol, Dominic Spadia, stand up when I see so people see who you are. Get over there. Okay. Very good. Okay, Francesca DiMare. Okay. Amina Wright. Rasby. You know I killed English language because I figured this out right for many, many years. Okay, so not a problem. Deborah Silva, and filling in is Brian Fan. He's a junior though, but he looks like a senior. Okay. So hope you enjoy this little future. There'll be an exam on MCAS next week, but not on the lineup. That's right. We got Britain kids. They've been testing since 5 weeks ago. I don't know what they're testing for, but I finally recognize them. They haven't been gone for half the time. But anyway, you ready? All right, so a little thing called Sparkling Flutes. Enjoy it.
Thank you.
is like the Lawrence Walk Show. We have everything tonight. The people who remember here. It was ahead of his time, wasn't it? Now the next number was actually, this is one of my favorite numbers. It's beautiful, beautiful waltz, and the kids get to learn what it was. But it's an interesting story. It's written by the serious composer, Dmitri Shostakovich, which is to them was a joke. Back in those days, music like this was called jazz music, but really to us it's almost like pop music. So they said to him, you can't write jazz, you're very serious here. So he wrote a whole series of what they call the jazz suites, but they're not really the jazz as we recognize it today. So this is one of the pieces, a long time ago we did the entire suite, which is fabulous, fabulous performance. So actually wrote, now for you millennials out here, this is not an instrument that was just invented. Okay? This is called an accordion. Okay, I have no clue what it was. Okay? And it takes a lot of brains to do it, because you have to move your parts in 15 different ways, and you can't Google them all at the same time. Okay? So, remember, for those people around our age, accordions and pianos were part of the family traditions. At night, when we went there for supper, we were not on the phones, we were not on the television, we were playing music with Graham and so on and having a great family time. And this thing here, unfortunately, is a lost art, and so is piano today. You know how many people call me up, they want to give away pianos. It's an unfortunate thing that, you know, those little things have taken over what, you know, used to be part of the, you know, getting together Sunday dinners and all that stuff. So you're gonna bring it back a little bit. I didn't know Maggie played this thing when she showed up. You know, I can play the accordion. Okay. So she walked in with a little accordion, plus a trumpet, and so on. So this has been enjoyed. It's just, and the kids really, actually, when they, you know how you can tell, when I say, okay, let's do this, just a accordion goes, yes! You can hear that underneath it. So do kids love great music? Yeah, I'm just gonna expose it to them. So I hope you enjoy this waltz. It's a beautiful piece. All set? You go to the movies, yell at the screen? Oh, no, okay, let's go. Thank you. So the last piece that I was talking about that I said to the record, I'm going to give you 2 weeks to do it. It's a piece I call Ride, R-I-D-E. And this thing is was written by this composer, and actually was asked by this other composer to go to a consortium of music. And he took him to a ride from Indiana through his car, going like 100 miles an hour. And he just saw himself flying up there, passing trees, doing so on, and just kind of gave him a little bit of the vision of his friend's lead foot, as he said, to write this piece. So it's called Ride, done in real, a lot of multimeters. I think a while to put this together, but I want to just say these kids are going to put it together in about 2 weeks. I gave them 2 weeks to do that. Last time, we've done it 3 times, and you absolutely have enjoyed it. And also, what a way to end this thing, because most of the time I tell the students, a lot of kids here today, the seniors, which I'm going to recognize in a minute, is this piece here, for the most part, will end their musical career or performing after this. It's kind of, of course, it's sad, but a lot of kids say, well, we're going to play. No, you really don't. It's just the fourth grade they've done. So it makes them think a little bit and let them, you know, just through all the years. I let the last note stand, just go back all the time that you have to yell for them to practice. And now it's really has come on here. So first of all, about last time, recognition to our seniors on this stage. Now, you so much. Thank you for coming. Well, how about another hand for the concert band, Black Forest, concert choir, Mr. Penny, Mr. Thank you all for coming. Support us in a great summer, okay?